Ciao a tutti and welcome to another video. So for today we are gonna do another art journal page. I hope that you are prepared and so let's start it. So I'm gonna start directly drawing some sketchy line with my pencil on the page. The idea of this page is about music, so I will have a piano on the bottom, some musical note here and there, and some music text. I got the inspiration for this page watching a bench on a park. I saw that the seat of the bench was really the piano, and then the back of the bench was some musical note. So I decided to replicate pretty much the same style, but adding more colors. So I will start the page directly. Putting directly some ink, distress ink. I'm trying then to blend three colors there. So I will start with the yellow and then I will move to pink and finally to blue. Trying to put the color one on top of the other one. So I will have a good transition, a good blend. So I will have like the yellow and the pink together. I will create an orange section, and then the blue and the pink will create together a violet, a purple section. I'm gonna put all the name of the colors and the tools that I'm gonna use directly on the text on the video. So then, since my pronunciation is not so good, in this way I think it's easier to everybody to understand what I'm doing. And so that's the blending part. I'm speed up this process during editing because usually it's the process that take the most of the time, and there is not much interesting about that. But again, let me know if you prefer a bit slower, let's say. For the moment, I decided not to have a longer video, so just to make it kind of 10 minutes pretty much. But again, let me know if you prefer a different way I can adjust it. Another thing that I want to say is that I want to apologize for last week that I couldn't post any video. Basically, in the last few weeks, I usually have only a Friday to work on my art project, and few of the past Friday I was busy searching for a new school for my son. He turned 5 years old, and he's gonna do to kindergarten, so I'm really trying to find the right school. And yeah, let's see how it's going, because I'm still searching for it. Now, what I'm doing here, I'm not introducing any other color, but I'm using the same color code combination, but just stamping in different section, so to have like the pink on the orange section, the blue on the pink, etc, etc. And I'm using a stamp, is a cube, and there are four type of stamp. I'm just using one of them with some leaves and floral set. And then after that I'm moving to the piano, so I'm just drawing the piano with my black marker, and I'm checking with the picture just to make sure that I'm putting the black keys, piano keys, on the right place. And I'm doing everything by hands, but yeah, if you prefer you can use a ruler, but for me I'm really not a fan of the ruler in general. To be honest, I think it's too easy to smash or smear using the ruler while you are with a marker, instead of doing by hands, even if it's not really straight on. I mean, it's my art journal, I mean, it's fine, I guess. But again, if you want to be more precise and replicate the same art journal page, and you want to use a ruler, I think it's will be even better. Now, moving on to the white section for the piano. I'm gonna use the white Uni Posca pen. This is 2.5 millimeters, and I'm just coloring the section with this white color. You can think that I may choose a different page, a white page, but I really wanted to have this kind of vintage vibe. So then I was really using the brown page of my art journal, because my art journal is they have it has some pages in white and some pages are in brown, but I really wanted to have this brown so I could have color the section, the white section of the piano with the Posca. So this is having kind of, I like the idea to have those straight lines in white that are not perfectly colored. I started just doing by section, like first the top section of the keys, then the middle, and then the last part of the keys. But I have to say that in the end, I was doing better. So I think the better technique for the Uniposca is to have really straight line continuously from the beginning, from the top to the bottom. So in this way, you will have a more bright white color, and you will see on the right page of the of those piano keys. Anyway, while I'm coloring, I leave you with some music. This is anyway, this is also a page about music, so why not? And I cannot put the same music that inspired me during this process, because I think YouTube will not like, but I will try to find a similar rock vibe. Okay, I'll catch you later. After that, so I'm want to have the violin key on the left of the page. I want a big and huge violin key, and that's where I'm drawing by hand again using the same black pen marker. And I'm doing a kind of a sketch first with that thin line, but then I'm going to make it bold on some of the section, so adjusting while I'm after doing the first sketch. Now, I'm gonna cut the section on the bottom of the piano, and if you saw my last few video, you will notice that I'm becoming a kind of a, I'm I like the process now to cut really the page. I'm doing basically because my art journal is a bit too bold, but I like the idea to cut it, and that's you will see often on my page. So now on the section on the bottom, I want to have a bold black color, so I'm using my distress ink. And then here I just zoom it, and you can see that on that section I'm gonna use the Posca pen to draw some musical notes randomly. So to have it a random draw, I prefer to really move the art journal in different direction. In this way it's easier to draw more random drawing. And you will see also that I made a mess as always. I have to make a mess once in a while. And so I just put my hands while I was drawing on another musical note that was not completely dry, and then I smash the Posca, the white Posca, on the black section. But I'm gonna correct the mistake, so you will see later on that I'm gonna use some black pencil, normal just black pencil, to kind of fade a little bit more that the white that smashed. And I think in the end you cannot see anymore the mistake, so I think it's a pretty good way to solve, let's say, the mistake that happened. And anyway, every project happens something, I know, and you need really to solve it in a quick way. Then, after that, I'm gonna glue all the pages together with my matte medium Liquitex. And then after gluing, it's time for the quote. The quote of today is about a lyric song, it's an Italian song, and the title is Meraviglioso, that means wonderful. And this song is from 1968 or around that, but I'm they redo the song quite often, and the one that I like the most is the one from Negramaro, that is an Italian group. And I'm trying to translate in English what I'm putting there. This is really the lyric of the song. So it's wonderful, look around you, the gift that they gave you, they invented for you the sea, you say you don't have anything, does the sun means nothing to you, life, love, wonderful, a woman that love only you, the light of a morning, the hug of a friend, the face of a child. I think it's beautiful, and I really had to replicate it. I'm gonna finish the page with some highlights with the Posca pen. And that's it for this page. I hope that you like it and you got inspired. If you want, just let me know your favorite song. Just leave a comment below. You will see a close-up pictures in the end of this video. And I'll also leave, if you want to see more video, art journal video inspiration, I'll leave the link to my playlist on the right of the end screen. Again, thank you for watching and see you soon. Bye bye!